gear up for a jam-packed episode. We're getting our very own taste of Bollywood, checking out Oddball, one of the latest flicks to hit the big screen. And our sports reporters, Lockie, Kyle and Thomas, head to the Gabba for some game day fun.
Annabelle, your host today for Juice TV. We're on location at Lady Salento Children's Hospital, and we've got a great episode lined up for you today. Coming up shortly, we have some Bollywood dancing, which I cannot wait to see. But first,
it's time for quick questions. This week's host is also known as Bella. She loves to read and also eats raw fish. Let's get to know her a little better. It's Annabelle.
I am 14 years old. My favourite sport is netball, and I play goal defence. My favourite movie is Rio, because the music is spectacular in it. My favourite animal is a dog. I have a dog at home called Miles, and he's a Staffy cross-border collie. The grossest food I've ever eaten is a Brussels sprout. Yuck. Definitely lick your toes. I'm really good at English, and I love writing essays. My favourite place to go would be back to England. I love the rolling hills there. My favourite song is Holocene by Bon Iver. The best and only dance move I can do is the shuffle. Unfortunately, I'm on crutches and I cannot perform this. I can make a three-leaf clover with my tongue. If I could have any superpower, it would be telekinesis, because I can move myself anywhere. Now let's go to Jade and Dance Masala, who are on the party deck, for some Bollywood dancing. Salam, salam.
Namaste, I'm Jade, and these are the beautiful girls from Dance Masala. Welcome to Juice TV, ladies. Thank you for being on our show. Please introduce yourselves.
I'm Yamesha.
I'm Drea.
My name is Samiha.
And I'm Girija.
Firstly, can you tell us what Dance Masala is about?
Yeah, absolutely. Dance Masala is a Bollywood dance company. It's based here in Brisbane, and we do all sorts of different classes, lots and lots of performances, and yeah, it's all Indian kind of cinematic dance.
That's really cool.
It is. It's pretty cool.
Samiha, what is Bollywood?
So the best way I could describe Bollywood is basically Indian version of Hollywood, and all the movies are a minimum of 3 hours long because there's 8 dancers going for 10 minutes. Yeah, right? Okay, so I grew up with Bollywood and I grew up knowing all the corny storylines like boy meets girl, boy never gets the girl, or there's always some sort of like marriage or like family conflict, or she's too good for him, or and then he just chases her for like 3 hours, and then at the end they get together and they get married, and there's always like a mountain scene where they're showing their love, and then yeah, it's great.
Or they're in Paris.
Yeah, Paris is a recent development, and normally it's the mountains, but it's full of color, it's full of laughter, it's full of brightness. And it's always been like a shining part of my life, and I'm so glad to be part of it, yeah.
Girija, what is your favorite thing about Bollywood dancing?
My favorite thing about Bollywood dancing is probably how corny and cheesy it is. It's so great to be able to just let loose and be crazy and do all sorts of insane things which you normally can't do with other dance styles, and it just looks so at home with Bollywood, and that's what makes the dance so much better. Like, the cornier and cheesy you are, the better the dancing looks.
Why do you dance in bare feet?
Well, it's because of traditional Indian dance forms. So there's other sorts of Indian dances called Bhadanatyam and Kathak, which are all bare feet. So pretty much Bollywood has been adapted for it. Like, you can say ballet has kind of, jazz has been kind of adapted from ballet. So yeah, we dance in bare feet. It's a lot more fun like that, I think. Like, you can do a lot more things without shoes on.
Does it hurt your feet?
No, it actually doesn't. Well, obviously it depends on the flooring, but if it's a normal wooden sort of floor, then it's absolutely fine. It doesn't hurt at all.
Do you have bare feet in every dance?
Yes, definitely. So every dance we do is all with bare feet.
What is the beautiful dot between your eyes?
So this is called a bindi. It's sort of like a fashion accessory these days, but it does have quite an ancient cultural significance back in India. So it has been used to represent a third eye. It can also show that a woman is married, but these days you can use it to sort of just jazz up your outfit, make yourself look more Indian, or, you know, just make any outfit look a bit dressier.
Now that we've learned about Bollywood dancing, let's go watch the beautiful girls in action. Girls, that was amazing. Are you guys exhausted?
Yes, definitely.
I loved how you guys could like tell the story with your body. Can you tell me a little bit about that?
Yeah, absolutely. Like, so my character had a mustache and so that was meant to signify that I'm a man, okay? So, yes, the mustachioed character is a very common kind of archetype. Heroes often have mustaches, villains often have mustaches. I was a little bit both. yeah, and just, it's very hard to tell a boy meets girl love story without a boy.
There was some dance move that you guys did like over and over again. Can you tell us about that?
Sure, okay, so the classic one is the dunka, so you put like one leg out and then one just like hip, and then you move your hips like that, and also sometimes you put it on your head as well. That's you saw that in basically all of the dances. Yeah. Yeah, that's it. Yeah.
And we've got drama queen as well. Hi. And then with Dumka. You wanna try? Hi.
So girls, we've got some friends coming down to learn some moves. Are you ready?
Yeah, let's do it.
Woo!
Okay guys, it seems like we're all warmed up and we're ready to do some dancing. We're going to do a dance today. It's called Tuna Mariantrian. So, the first step of Tuna Mariantrian. We're gonna take our hands, and it's like the hands of a clock. Now you might not have that much room next to you to kind of do it really wide, so you can do it in front of you. We're gonna turn one. So grab all the things, turn two, turn three, and turn four. Now we're gonna let it go the out. Out, 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 out. We're gonna go down to up, up, good job, and up, two, down, three, and down. Go up, up, and up, and up. You can look at your hands as well, or just focus on one hand, because that's a bit easier. All right, and go. Close your eyes, and I want you to imagine a big elephant, okay? You see that big elephant? It's huge. He's at the bank, and he's stuck in the doorway of the bank. He's at Westpac, and he can't get through the door. All right, we're gonna push him, okay? So we're gonna push down, two, three, back up, up, two, three, up, down, two, three, and up, two, three, last one, go forward, two, three, go back, up, two, three, four, good job. Okay, so we're gonna sing, the bells are ringing in my heart, all right? And you can sing it with expression, all right? So we're just gonna point, you're just gonna point. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, we're gonna hit the bell. One, two, three, and this is where you go, dun, 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 aye, dun, dun, dun. All right, ready? Let's see if we remember all this stuff.
much fun. What if kids want to get involved?
Well, we've actually run Bollywood dance classes, and we do kids' birthdays and all different sorts of workshops. So you can hop on our website. The best way to find it is bollywoodbrisbane.com.au. And you can find out all about our classes and hop onto our YouTube, check out our videos, like us on Facebook, do all the fun things.
Thanks, girls, for being on Juice TV. We've had so much fun.
Thank you for having us.
That's it from the party deck. Bye. Bye.
That looks like fun. Thank you, Jade, and thank you so much, Dance Masala, for that lovely performance. Now let's check in with our very own Juice TV sports reporters, who are at the Gabba, the home of the Brisbane Lions.
Hi, my name's Thomas, and I'm with my brother Carl at the Gabba to meet the Brisbane Lions.
Got out the Brisbane Lions change room and what just happened.
We met Mitchell Robertson and he gave me the shoe.
What is the coolest thing coming to the Gabba today?
Meeting the Brisbane Lions players. They train hard and they work as a team and they never give up.
Who is your favourite player?
Alan Christensen.
How fast can you run?
Pardon? How fast can I run? Nah, not very fast. I'm not very fast, unfortunately, but I'll try and be fast in my head.
Do you like playing AFL?
Yeah, I love it. It was a dream as a kid. All I wanted to do was play AFL. So I was very lucky that I get to live my dream, and I've been doing it for 6 years now. So.
Oh, when did you start AFL?
So I started playing as a kid when I was 4 or 5. And then I was lucky enough to get drafted when I was 18. So it's I've been lucky to play AFL all my life, pretty much.
What do you eat before you play a game?
So I stick to a little routine. I usually have a bit of Spanish just to mix it up. So a bit of chorizo and some nice rice and stuff like that. So I make sure I get a good meal in, and then the morning of a game I get to have pancakes because it's the only day of the week I get to eat naughty food. So the morning of a game I get to have pancakes.
How do you kick the goal so straight?
Well, I'd always like to kick a little bit straighter, but when we have shots with goal, we have a set routine. So I like to take 4 or 5 steps. I hold the ball pretty straight and I run straight at the goals. So my dad used to tell me, if you run straight, you kick straight.
Do you train a lot?
Yeah, we're nearly here every day, so it's like school. So we get here in the morning, we don't leave till the afternoon. So it's a pretty hard job. It's a long job, but so we train about 3 times a week. We do weights, bit of other stuff, a lot of meetings. So yeah, it's a long time we're down here, but. You know, it's what I always wanted to do, so yeah, you take the good and the bad.
How much does the shoes cost?
Well, I'm very lucky that we get a lot of our stuff for free because we're professional athletes, but I wear bright ones, so my nana, when she watches at home, she can see me on the TV. So these are brand new, so hopefully when I run out there tomorrow, she'll see me in them and she'll know who I am. So.
Thank you for joining us on Juice TV.
We'll Thanks, guys. Thanks for having me. Good questions.
When you were kicking the ball, did you score a goal?
I scored all of them.
He's a better kicker than you or Duck O'Brien?
Me.
He kicked harder than you.
Oh, well, I need to practice as well.
I'm Kyle, thanks for coming down today. We really appreciate it. On behalf of the Brisbane Lions, we know you're going through a tough time, and anything we can do to help, more than happy to do that. And it's been great to have you down here, and the boys are happy to see you. And mate, all the best in the future, and your health and everything going forward. Keep your chin up, and yeah, we're here to support you, mate. So have a good one.
Good man.
Thank you.
Hey guys, I'm here watching the AFL Bulldogs.
Hello mate.
Hey mate.
How are you doing?
Good.
Good handshake.
Thanks.
Nice meeting you.
Yeah. What's your secret weapon?
My secret weapon is the little fella right there that wears a helmet, because he's the one that kicks it to me. Otherwise, I don't get a kick, so I rely on him.
What are you gonna have for dinner?
For dinner? I think the club might put on some pasta. Jake loves his pasta, so he'll get stuck into that. He's a big boy, he eats a fair bit, so he'll get into that, I reckon. What about you, mate? What are you having for dinner?
Some noodles.
Some noodles?
Or something, yes. Are you gonna beat the lion?
Oh, I hope so, mate. I hope so. We'll be doing everything we can to get a win. So, yeah, we think we're good enough to do it. And then hopefully go on and win a few finals. Yep.
Work hard or stay home and kick straight.
All right, we'll try.
Good on you, Lachlan. Are you coming to the game tomorrow?
Yes.
Yeah, good stuff. We'll see you here, eh? Try and get a win for you.
How awesome was that, guys? I met the players and fans and everyone. Can't wait for the game.
Yay!
While the boys get ready for the game day, it's time to check out the latest from the big screen with Beck.
Hey guys, it's Beck here from Event Cinemas, and I'm here to review another film for you. This one's called Oddball. This film's based on a true story and is set in Australia. And I can guarantee you one thing, you're going to fall in love with the main character, whose name is Oddball. Let's check out the trailer now.
In a remote part of the world, there's a magical island where thousands of the littlest penguins of them all make their home. But foxes found the island, and in just a few short years, there were hardly any penguins left. Their only hope now lies...
Oddball, where are you, mate?
...with a rather mischievous dog.
This is the third time the dog's been in trouble. Oddball stays confined to your farm.
Well, Oddball isn't dangerous.
Last chance.
What are you so vent about?
Dad, the penguins are almost gone. If we're below 10 next month, council is shutting us down.
Eccentric chicken farmer Swampy Marsh convinces his community to allow Oddball the dog to protect a colony of little penguins on Middle Island from feral animals. Oddball the sheepdog, played by Kai, was discovered at the RSPCA, and the penguins were flown in from our very own SeaWorld on the Gold Coast.
There must be some way to scare off the foxes.
Well, I'll be blowed.
I think if we put Oddball on that island, he'll protect the penguins.
Don't you think taking him to the island is pretty risky?
You want the biscuit, you got to risk it.
Okay.
This can work. Oddie's got it in him. I gave you hell
through all these. Let's see what Oddie's made of.
Yeah. No. Oddball!
You realise if anyone finds out, Oddball's done for.
Stop that dog!
Looks like we're in business. It's the end of the line.
Oddball!
Has everyone lost their mind?
We skip for the biscuit. Oddball!
Oh, wow.
That
didn't make an onion cry.
So round up some friends to see Oddball from September 17th. I'll be back next time to review another awesome movie. See you later.
We want you to be a part of Juice TV. We're always on the lookout for hosts, interviewers, behind-the-scenes helpers and mini producers. You can be any age. You don't have to have any experience. How much easier could it be? To find out the next time we're filming at the hospital, just head to our website, juicedtv.com.au, or our Facebook page. For loads of fun to break up your stay in hospital, join the Juice crew. Send us an email at hello@juicetv.com.au or speak to any of the volunteers wearing green shirts throughout the hospital and let them know you want to be involved in the one and only Juice TV. It's game day and our Juice TV reporters are super excited for their first ever match at the Gabba.
Here we are at the Gabba, Brisbane Lionford Bulldogs. We're our Western Bulldogs. We're going for the Brisbane Lions.
So lucky that Brisbane Lions get a win today.
Go Doggies!
Sorry, Tom. The Brisbane Lions have got no chance.
The friendly rivalry has begun.
Lucky, may the best team win.
Good luck, Tommy.
Kyle decided to try his hand at running commentary, and despite the Lions falling behind, he offers some words of encouragement to his team.
Hey, Christensen is number three. You can see him with his bright green shoes. I'm proud of Christensen. They're trying their best to win this game. So far, they are losing, but they might come back. There's Alan Christensen. There, he got the ball and he kicks it.
Here's a go. Here's a go. That's it. Run, yes. Boys, run.
The scores is 17-42, but they could come back soon.
That was the end of the first quarter. We're doing well, the Doggies. Kick straight. We've got 8 straight goals, 48 points on the board. The Lions were only 17 points, so we got a good lead. How did you think that went, that quarter?
Good.
What were they doing so well that's making them, making their score so good?
Communication and ball skills. And just being them.
Good teamwork, I reckon, hey, son?
Yeah.
After a disappointing start for the Lions, the fans stay loyal, and then a miraculous turn of events.
The Brimpen are going to get another goal.
Here we go again. Easy as you like. Lewis Taylor, open goal. And can you believe this? Brisbane are in front.
The Lions have 51 and the Bulldogs have 48.
They tried their best because they had a good play and they had some energy and they'll probably win this game.
Go Brisbane Lions, you're the best. We're really proud of them.
They want to take them on. They're playing with such confidence. Adcock, well done. Got around.
Yes!
Over the top.
Yes!
Christensen.
Yes!
Six in a row.
King it.
Pops it over the top. Easy as you like. Daniel McStay.
Yeah! Yeah! Yeah, they just got to go. Now 59-48. How do you reckon Tom, Rocky feeling?
Very, very sad.
Go Lions.
Go Bulldogs.
Minutes remaining now in this half. Bontempelli, there it is, the luxury that Tim spoke of, the Bont of all knowledge.
That's better, Lockie. Now we're in front again. It was looking not very good there the first half, mate. But
yeah,
we managed to get a couple of goals back and it's a close game again. We're in front by 3 points. So what have we got to do to kick some more goals again?
Just keep what they're doing. Motivation.
A Okay, the Lions have come back strong, and they're going to win.
Here's a chance. I think he's brought it back all the way.
The Lions just scored a goal. That puts him back in front, Lockie.
Yeah, you reckon Alan Christensen will get a goal before this game finished?
Yeah.
Right now they're concerned with this Dogs outfit. Make it this Lions outfit who keep punching forward. And Christensen to make it an 8-point lead. Wonderful touch from Daniel Rich. How is the finish from the former Cat? It is perfect. Out to 8 points, the Lions.
Alan Christensen just got a goal for us, and he promised us yesterday that he's going to get a goal. And he just got a goal. What an amazing kick he did. Right, Thomas?
Yeah.
That was awesome.
And Jed Adcock, he finishes his career as a Brisbane Lion as a winner. Brisbane against the odds. Nobody expected it. They win by 8 points.
After a nail-biting finale, the Lions came home with the goods, and our Juice reporters were all smiles and cheers.
Yeah! We are very exciting! What a good game!
Had an awesome day at the Gabba today and spent time with my family. And I got to see the doggies. They fought to the end.
Wow, what an exciting game, wasn't it, Craig?
Yes, it was, Kyle. Brisbane Lions played very well. You deserve the win. Well done.
Congratulations, Brisbane Lions. And good job, boys. You looked like you had a roaring good time. That's it for this episode. Until next week, bye for now.
Remember, guys, it's so easy to be a part of Juice TV. Whether you want to be a host, help us out behind the scenes with filming, or decide what goes into each episode, let us know you want to be involved by sending an email to hello@juicetv.com.au or speak to one of the friendly volunteers throughout the hospital in the green shirts. Also, head to our website and Facebook page for all the updates about what we're filming at the hospital. Juice.